Claude Dornier is preparing to fly his plane across the Atlantic. The flight plan for the DOX is a logistical nightmare. Dornier decides to take off from West Africa and fly across the South Atlantic. Then, from Brazil, he will fly north up the coast of South America to the US and on to New York City. But will there be enough fuel to cover the enormous distance?
They used a special technique. The plane flew at a very, very low altitude, about 10 or 20 meters above the sea. At this height, it could use the ground effect, a sort of air cushion that increased the range of the flying boat by about 5%. That made a difference, as every kilometer counted, and they even flew at night by moonlight. It was risky, but Kramer von Clausbrück was an experienced pilot who had done it before with other Dornier seaplanes. He knew what he was doing, and so they continued skimming the surface through the night.
Even though the pilot, von Clausbrück, is experienced, it will still be incredibly risky. An Atlantic storm or an encounter with an ocean liner could be deadly. The DOX covers 1,700 miles in less than 16 hours and reaches the Brazilian coast at dawn. From there, it turns north toward New York City. On August 27, 1931, thousands of spectators wait on the piers of the Hudson River to greet the flying boat. They give the DOX a rousing welcome. It's one of the greatest engineering feats of the 20th century. Claude Dornier has made it. He has successfully crossed the Atlantic on a nonstop flight in the world's first large passenger plane.